Intruder alert. Intruder alert. Security breach at gate 3. Intruder has been located in the north quadrant and is moving in the direction of the underground base. All units prepare to engage. Emergency battle formations. Standard battle procedures initiated. Locate and stop the intruder from entering the security area. This is not a drill. Repeat, this is not a drill.
That was all too easy. Let's take a look at what my grandfather was working on. A top secret military weapon. The military shut down the research because they feared it.
And welcome back to Sonic Adventure 2 Battle. Last time we finished up the hero side story, and this time we're starting the dark side story. So, we're starting off with a bit of a bang, but literally and figuratively, as Dr. Eggman storms a government facility. Gee, I wonder what he's gonna find here, having already played the hero story, but as a word of caution, or not really caution, but just as a note, I'm going to be not talking over cutscenes still, because I don't know, there's a chance maybe some prefer to start with the dark side. So I'm actually not going to act too much like you haven't, or you have seen the other part. I'm gonna act like, you know, you haven't seen it. So this is Eggman's first level. It's very reminiscent to Prison Lane in overall structure, but we have the unique gimmick of having doors. By the way, break those, you got a wall, but you can see a power up back there that we cannot access, so keep that in mind for the future.
Level 3 security door breach.
This is actually a really good intro level, and honestly, for the shooting levels, Dr. Eggman definitely has an edge over Tails because the mechs are just better placed. I use the term mech interchangeably with different things, but in this case I mean the actual, like, robots. Oops. That was unexpected, but there was a checkpoint right here, so no big. Yeah, speed shoes. They sometimes don't really help you that much. So yeah, getting off to a good start, clearly. So we'll probably end up with a C at best, because I think we died early enough in the stage in order to at least salvage it a little bit. But we're not getting an A, I can already guarantee you. Basically, one of the most important things for A ranking stages is just not dying, because of your base score being such an important factor. Which is actually a far cry from other Sonic games where it's all time-based. Basically everything after colors ended up being very much time-based rather than score-based, so it's a lot harder to get good ranks, and it makes the overall experience much tougher. But back in these games, you actually have to have a decent balance of score, rings, time, a bunch of different factors, and thus it actually makes for a more satisfying victory when you actually do manage to get an A rank. Anyway, that's Iron Gate, pretty standard. I'm actually curious to see what this ends up being, probably a D or C. Oh, I overestimated just a tad.
So this is the military's top secret weapon. It's a lot smaller than I expected. Enter user data. Enter password. Password is Maria. Maria.
Now all I have to do is to place the Chaos Emerald into this console.
Spoil my plans again. Wait a minute. You're not Sonic. This is impossible.
My name is Shadow. Since you were so kind to release me, my master, I will grant you one wish.
Now what?
Behold the true power I possess.
This is Scorpion Troops Hotshot. Enemy movement has been detected. En route to intercept and destroy.
Copy that.
So now we're in control of Shadow, who plays pretty much identically to Sonic, and also his first boss is pretty much a copy of Sonic's, but it's actually kind of annoying to deal with because of reasons that will become clearer when we actually start showing off some other stuff in the Hero Side story. So yeah, you can jump, you can homing attack. He has a new attack where he tries to lock onto you. It's just the same fight, but a little bit harder and sadly more drawn out. You really want to make sure he doesn't break the boxes. That's like your number one priority, as odd as it sounds, because then you have more room to maneuver. So that wasn't too bad.
Pathetic humans.
Destroying that guard robot was spectacular. So, Shadow, you are the military's top secret weapon. But what did you mean when you said you will grant me a wish?
Bring more Chaos Emeralds.
Shadow, wait!
I'll be waiting for you in the central control room on the Space Colony Ark.
Ark.
Just let it go. You just don't know when to give up, do you?
What are you talking about? That emerald's mine. You got that? The Master Emerald contains special powers that neutralize the energy of the Chaos Emeralds. That makes it very powerful.
What the? What? Me?
Look who's calling who a thief.
I came here following the signal from the Emerald. If I'm not mistaken, this is the Master Emerald, is it not? Dr. Eggman.
So that's Dr. Eggman.
Well, I was looking for something. I'll just take it with me. Farewell.
Not if I can help it.
What was that all about? And look what you did to my emerald!
I did that to prevent the Master Emerald from being stolen, you idiot. If it's in pieces, I can restore. And by the way, that's not your emerald.
I'll get into it once I get back to the base.
So one problem with that cutscene, where are they? Like, where the heck are they? And why is the Master Emerald in the desert? Because Eggman is clearly flying towards his pyramid. So that weird sound is a turtle over here. So we have to break these two robots in order to free the turtle, and that's important for a little bit. So the main gimmick is the turtle, but the first emerald piece is actually not where the turtle goes. So let's try to figure out where this sucker is without actually using the map for the heck of it. It's close. Oh, huh, that's sneaky. So Dry Lagoon's a pretty small stage, and I actually have no objections to the fact that it's pretty compact. The main gimmick is the turtle can transport you between two areas, so structurally it's very similar to Wild Canyon, where you have a vertical area that culminates in two branching paths to the left and the right. The main difference is, I think this is Emerald is actually in the jerkish spot. The main difference is you have to use the turtle to get to this area. So it's like an extra step to Wild Canyon, so it is a little harder. So I have a guess of where the Emerald is, and that guess involves riding this turtle. Sadly, Rouge does not get any sort of infinite air accessories, so you just kind of have to cross your fingers that you don't run out of air. I guess it's not here. Okay. That was kind of a waste of time then. Unless... Nope. Nothing here. Well, there can be an emerald here usually, so I mean, you might as well check here. Obviously there wasn't this time, but oh well. And going out of this tunnel, you don't need the turtle, because it's an airflow thing. Okay, so that eliminates one possibility. Maybe it's over here. Nope. It's definitely low. I'm actually kind of lost. Like, I'm legitimately confused by where this could be. Oh, there is... Not there. But yeah, you also have to surface periodically, which makes this whole situation take a lot longer. Yeah, I'm legitimately kind of confused by where this is. Okay, that is really well hidden. Cool. So if we don't get a blip soon, it probably is in the main area, so let's actually head back once we check over on the other side. Or it's over here. That works for me. Okay, so it's... It feels like it's moving. Because it keeps changing. Did I just see it? Or not? I don't think so, actually. But yeah. Oh. It was just green, so I couldn't see it. Lovely.
It's all too easy for me.
That's an ominous start. Getting a B on Rouge's first stage, that can only bode well.
Those idiots will never find my hidden base inside this pyramid. Let's take a vacation here first, then get inside.
Sorry, Eggman, I can't hear you over the sound of all these torches. Now, you can make this cycle in one go, it's really hard. Especially when you're first playing this level, it gets easier actually, because you get a hover later on. So, this level becomes somewhat trivial, but on the first go, you're gonna have a bad time. You're not gonna have fun trying to get an A rank without all the equipment. So if you really want A ranks as Eggman, wait. You're not gonna get most of them first try just because of them being really, really intricate. You have to lock onto a lot more than with Tails, for example. And honestly, I think that's actually one of the pros of Eggman's stages is Tails' stages are kind of an afterthought in that you don't really need to lock on that much, but Eggman, you really need to use his abilities. Or you could just die immediately. First jump after the checkpoint. But again, this is why I say don't bother until after you get all the upgrades, because this level in particular is a little bit difficult if you're going without upgrades. I almost didn't make that jump there from the rotating platform to the moving one, case in point. On the whole, this isn't a bad level, it's just not as remarkable. And it's very platform heavy, which doesn't really work well when you're in a robot mech. There's stuff over there to the left, but yeah, we don't have any means of getting that item yet, so let's just keep going. Okay, I misjudged. Momentum messed me up there, because I couldn't jump back to the platform in time. Or I couldn't move in the air enough to actually land on it after I miscalculated. But yeah, this can only bode well. The Dark Side story is a lot harder, just as a general note. You're gonna have a lot more trouble with these stages compared to the Hero Side, so that's why most people say start with the Hero Side, even though chronologically, the Dark Side starts first. Which actually creates a bit of a plot hole, but we'll find that out next time. So, there's a stack of containers here, you just have to break them all, like so, not too bad. Yeah, on the whole, the stage isn't difficult, it's just a little bit finicky sometimes. I think that might be the, no, we still have a ways to go, this isn't exactly a short level. Time this. Again, when you have the hover, you can kind of just fly through the stage and it's really fun, but doing it without the hover, it's kind of not that fun. So yeah, it's definitely one of those levels where it's a little bit tricky to master all the little techniques to get top score, but once you do, it's actually really fun. And again, with more gear. Yeah, throwing in a platforming challenge before you even get the hover is a little bit jerkish actually. But that's gonna do it for now, so thank you for watching, and I hope you join me next time for more Sonic Adventure 2 Battle.
That was too close.